What you see in my hand here is a bronze medal. These bronze medals will go to the winner of our next game. Our bronze medal game here at the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, hosted by Greensboro Roller Derby.
Yes.
I am PR Armageddon.
I am Rippy Longstocking.
And we will be your guides on our WFTDA.tv broadcast stream for this amazing game between Rainy City Roller Derby and Dos Por Cuatro. It's going to be an amazing game. They've had a
very good.
It's been a very fun road coming to this game.
Yes.
One of these teams is going to punch their very first ticket to champs.
That's exciting.
And
that's
it's going to be amazing to see who gets to go to Montreal in November.
So they are 10th in the world and 12th in the world. That's Rainy City 10th. Dos Por Cuatro. Sorry about that. 12th in the world. So very closely ranked. And I think this would be a good game.
Oh, it's going to be an amazing, amazing game.
Exciting.
Let's go ahead and read off our rosters to you while we have a second. Starting off with Dos Por Cuatro, they will be in the black. Team Awesome. Number 03 is Timmy's. Number 14, Mandarina. 1807 is Dixon. Number 24, Ladrillo. 26, Tropical Mechanica, the captain. 265, Luluzan. Number 3 is Carla. 35 is Croatia. 45, Maki Lombrera. Number 4, Resho. Number 84, Persephone. Number 9 is Loba. And number 99 is Chinaski.
And for Rainy City Roller Derby, all stars in the purple will be 11, Faye Roberts. 16, 18, Fred Finta. 273, Ducky. 29, Penny Block. 311, Ella Diablo. 316, Lily Gaskell. 38, Blondie. 417, Stopless. 5, Lauren Swaffield. 6, Rascal. 7, Mia. 77, Liz Yateman. 81, Fairy Quake. And 88, Banshee.
And of course, Dos Por Cuatro coming from Buenos Aires, Argentina, and Rainy City coming from Manchester,
Manchester,
England, and United Kingdom. So some international flair, of course. We already have one non-United States team in champs already, which is Victorian Roller Derby League. So we will now have a second one coming out of this one for sure in this bronze medal game.
Indeed, yeah.
And of course, the game following us will be that gold medal game between Texas and Angel City. But we are right here, right now, getting ready for the bronze medal game. Rainy City in the purple, Dos Por Cuatro in the black. We're about a minute or so out. Let's give a quick shout out to our officials, both on skates and off. First, our NSOs, led by Le Corbusier, John Brawls, Judge Booty, Big Brad Wolf, Diamond Tiara. This will be painful. W.E.B. Destroys.
Boy.
Petey, Rule Booker, and Oh My Eyes. And our,
I'm sorry to interrupt you. There was some stuff going on here, but
okay,
I can't see that on the stream. But yes, I was gone for a second there.
Hard at work right here. Okay, and our skating officials led by Razor, Refty Venture, PH Demon, Shanksy, Adam Smasher, RDFM, Gym Class Hero, and Pika. Got a line up here for jam number one. I see number 81, Fairy Quake, at the line for Rainy City. Looks like number 26 for Dos Por Cuatro, that is Tropical Mechanica, will be the jammer. Bronze medal game about to come at you, jam number one. Going to be a very exciting game. Once again, one of these teams is going to be the first time ever they will reach the championship event. And it is quite an event.
If you haven't tuned in all weekend, this has been really amazing to watch
this
playoff event.
All right, swooping whistle means we're about 5 seconds and change out to our first jam. It gets rolling. And away we go. Again, Fairy Quake jamming for Rainy City. Tropical Mechanica is the jammer for Dos Por Cuatro. Back block penalty quickly off the whistle against Dos Por Cuatro. So they're down a blocker as we go. But Fairy Quake, oh, to the front. Had to do a little balancing act in turn one, but got through and earned lead jammer. First lead jammer does go to Rainy City. Pack still in turn number one. Another back blocking penalty. This time another one against Dos Por Cuatro. And, oh, that was against Tropical Mechanica. So it looks like we do have a power jam for Rainy City, a four-point pass for Fairy Quake. So early power jam advantage here for Rainy City. Fairy Quake to the inside, knock to the infield, going to quickly reset. Pack moving through the jam line. Fairyquake trying to push through the back, but Dos Pocuatro lining up a great wall and now edging Fairyquake outside in turn one. Forearm penalty assessed in the pack. Against Dos Pocuatro, the pivot to the penalty box. That is Maki Lombera. Fairyquake through in turn two, scoring pass complete for four. Pack still in turn one, trying to sort things out there as Fairyquake reapproaches for another scoring pass. Backs into the Dos Pocuatro wall. And these teams, this is not their first meeting. They've met previously.
It is not their first meeting.
So they do know each other at least somewhat well. So we'll see if that comes into to play here in this matchup. It's fast-moving pack now.
Oh.
Fairyquake is through for another four. And the star was passed by Dos Pocuatro to Maki Lombera. And a jam will be called. It looks like we have no points for Dos Pocuatro. Two additional points for Rainy City.
Right, and a little concern for Dos Pocuatro at this point, there we go, is three penalties on that first jam.
Yeah.
So that's something that could, may play a role in this.
I mean, one of those
match
was a jammer penalty,
yes,
too. So.
But, you know, still really early, but just to keep an eye on that.
Here we go. Lauren Swaffield is the jammer, number five for Rainy City, up against Luluzon for Dos Pocuatro. Furious action in the pack. Now a drawback on Lawrence Wallfield. That was done by Chinoski. Pack still not fully past turn number one, or past the pivot line for that matter. We've had a lot of turn one action all weekend long.
Oh, my goodness.
I feel like our medics and our EMT staff sitting in the corner have gotten a prime view all weekend long.
I feel like there might be a dip in the floor there. I feel like it's
might been
eating away.
Penalty assessed for Rainy City in the pack. Meanwhile, we have a lead at jammer, and it is Luluzon for Dos Pocuatro. And Luluzon approaching now on a scoring pass. Whistle blows in the pack. And through for the scoring pass. Luluzon picks up four. And a star pass completed by Rainy City. Star was passing number 88, Banshee. And jam will be called. Looks like 4 points picked up additionally there for Dos Pocuatro. Gives them eight. Rainy City at 14. 26-21 left on the game clock in our first period.
So, of course, the 2019 WFTDA playoffs are brought to you by the popular Rydell Solaris. Solaris, the performance you demand, the comfort you've been missing.
And we have lucky number sevens at the jam line. Looks like number seven for Rainy City, that is Mia with the star. And Dos Pocuatro, number seven is Rasho. So let's see which seven is going to get lucky as far as getting out for lead jammer.
Oh.
Mia trying to get through, but takes a slide job block out in turn number one. Going to get drawn back all the way to the jam line. And Rasho still in the front wall set up there by Rainy City, trying to get her way around. Mia does kind of squirt through, getting low in the turn one apex, does pick up lead. Pack still in that pivot line turn one area. And looks like Rasho did make it through on a star stash. Back block penalty assessed to Dos Pocuatro. That's number 03, Temis. And Mia calls off the jam. Looks like she picks up 3 points. That will increase Rainy City's lead now 17-8.
When you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick bearings where precision meets performance.
Speaking of quick, we've quickly already gotten to jam number four here in our
yes,
first period.
We have.
I see a number nine, Loba, is the jammer for Dos Pocuatro. Number 273, Ducky, is the jammer for Rainy City.
Ducky of Rainy City.
Whistle blows, jam underway. Ducky to the outside, now to the middle. Loba stuck in the back of the pack, looking to get around on an inside track. But again, both teams' walls setting up shop immediately.
Mm-hmm. The defense here has been ferocious.
Yes.
Say.
Not just in this game, but literally
yes,
all weekend
all
long.
All weekend.
Has been just outstanding defensive work by every team here. And Duncan going to get reset back to the jam line, courtesy of Chinoski.
30 seconds in. No lead jammer yet.
Still no lead jammer. and still not really past turn one again.
So, just interesting, I just want to point out Banshee on Rainy City Banshee number 88, trying to swoop in and help her jammer when she was unable to knock off a blocker. She just took her jammer by the hips and pushed her forward. We know if it works.
If you can't take a blocker out, get your jammer forward somehow.
Get the jammer forward.
And Ducky
that
just having
some do.
Ducky having some fits back here, and it's still supposed to brace two all. Whistles blowing in the pack. Penalty assessed for Rainy City. So a blocker to the penalty box. Now is, again, both of these walls just locking in place. We're actually almost to turn two now. Really?
Yes.
So we're making progress.
Miraculously.
Progress.
Turn two.
Loba trying to get through up front, taking a spill at the turn two exit. But nice work up front by Rainy City. I see number 77, Liz Yeatman, along with the pivot number 88, Banshee. And Loba just trying to do anything she can to get around, but credit to these Rainy City blockers.
Just not giving up, right?
Just but now, of course, having the bridge to keep the pack together, but Loba is able to continue. Lee Jammer does go to Loba.
10 seconds left on the jam clock. When
took a minute
when
and 50.
When we got lead. That
wow.
Is
that's a testament to these defenses.
Yes, it is.
We've been saying it all weekend long.
And, by the way, lead jammer picked up at turn three.
And that was the end of the jam. 1 point picked up by Loba. So all that work, all that hard hitting defense, one point. So the defenses had to come away smiling on that one. Both of them did.
You need to do your endurance stuff.
Yes.
When you
especially
are
in these matchups.
My goodness.
All right. Looks like number 26 for Dos Pocatro. That is Topico Mecanica, the captain. 81, Fairy Quake, once again jamming for Rainy City. And almost a scrum pack now starting to separate. Oh, and Fairy Quake trying to play Twister on the outside line.
Going
to have to reset.
Almost got up.
Yes.
Not quite. Oh, that was a beautiful little hit there. By
Fairy Quake now
going to
get. Yes, Fairy Quake going to reset back to the jammer line. And lots of just pushing and shoving going on in his pack. Fairy Quake trying to find an outside groove. I feel like the packs just are rotating along with the jammers here
just
on both sides.
So able to reform so quickly and just lock that jammer down.
Four-on penalty assessed to Rainy City. That's number 11, Faye Roberts. Still no lead jammer. And it's like another penalty picked up by Rainy City. And as soon as I say that, we have a lead jammer. It is Tropico Mecanica. So now on a scoring pass for Dos Pocatro. Tropico Mecanica working up front,
just
butting heads.
Tropico Mecanica is able to get a little space, there's that bumpy kind of jamming, you know, like that hit over and over.
Fairy Quake also through for her initial.
Yes.
Pat now in a turn three, jam will be called. No points on that pass. But a 4 point jam for Dos Pocatro closes the gap to four.
Inching up.
Wow. Slowly but surely.
Yes.
17-13 is your score. 20 minutes, 39 seconds to go in the first period. And on the replay,
the pow, 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 pow. That's
right.
Just the way.
Just takes the licking and keeps on rolling.
I mean, that is just amazing.
And I got to say, the great camera angles we've gotten all weekend long for our broadcast feed have been amazing.
Thank you to the broadcast crew.
Yes. We've had an amazing broadcast feed all weekend. And we're going to keep on going now as we have our jam on Lawrence Swaffield against the Luluzon. And again, just nobody going anywhere.
We are about an inch and a half in front of the jammer. Right?
Maybe if that. Forearm penalty assessed in the pack to Rainy City's pivot Banshee. And now the packs are going to move toward the pivot line and a quick drawback, or attempted drawback.
Swaffield. When Swaffield recycles, it's so fast.
Yeah, she's very quick, snaps back and goes.
Yeah, and that's how you have to do it to get in front of that recycler.
Still a lead jammer and still a basic scrum pack heading out of turn one into turn two. Nobody able to gain any kind of ground. And as soon as I say that, somebody decided to do that, and that was Luluzon picking up lead for Rainy City. I'm sorry, for Dos Pocatro. Apologies. Dos Pocatro. She is lead. Makes her escape through the pack. Now on a scoring pass.
So that might be three in a row for Dos Pocatro. It is.
Three in a row. You are correct, Rippy. And now, once again, we are locked down in turn, almost in turn three. And Rainy City trying to do their best to keep Luluzon from getting around to get those points. Swaffield still working on her initial. Whistle blow in the pack. Direction of gameplay penalty assessed to Rainy City.
Now, Swaffield has the star in hand, but, of course, unable to get...
And then the reacher pivot.
Her pivot is working very hard on that tripod.
And Dos Pocuazzo rushes the Rainy City wall as both jammers did escape. But only 4 points awarded, and that goes to Dos Pocuazzo. And we have a tie game.
Wow.
17 all.
Like that.
18 minutes and 27 seconds to go.
So we'll see if we're... Yes.
Look at the replay
so,
here.
Just want to give a shout out again. We were talking about our broadcast crew. Like, they are able to pick the one clip that we really want to show
you.
Right.
Well, they're listening to us.
Yes, they are.
They're like, oh, they talked about that.
And we're going to put that up there.
Excellent work. Oh. Here we go. Fairy Quake again. Bendy on the inside line right off the whistle. Meanwhile, number seven, Rasho at the front for Dos Pocuatro. And Rasho is through for lead.
I've been impressed with Rainy City. It's really important to be able to play one-on-one defense until you can, you know, get your blockers back with you. Mm-hmm. But they're able to just hang on for a really long time.
And a score pass complete. Sorry, for Rasho. 4 points. And lead change as we skate back in favor now of Dos Pocuatro. And a star pass has been made by Rainy City to number 316 to pivot. Now the jammer, Lily Gaskell.
Mm-hmm. Lily Gaskell has been a presence on the track, both defensively and offensively. And, of course, as soon as I say that.
As soon as you say that, track up penalty
look,
assessed.
Look, I was trying to brag on you, man.
And here we go now, power jam for Dos Pocuatro. And Rasho looking to get through in the front of the pack, but Rainey trying to get in front. Number 77, Liz Yeatman up there.
Yeah.
And wow, just again.
Not going to give it up.
No, not easily at all. And finally going to force a out of play block call as Rasho is through for four. The penalty did go against Yeatman. And Pack still coming out of turn three. Big hit, Rasho, but right back up. Like literally just bounced off of the track.
She made it elastic.
Ooh, I wish I had that kind of just elasticity.
Now here again, this is a two wall, but they do this interesting front back position thing.
Yeah,
and it is locked the jammer right in.
Watching the structure, Fairy Quake leaned in, put the hands behind her, mm-hmm. put the shoulders forward to create that brace and not risk a forearm penalty. 3 points picked up at the end of that jam. Dos Pocuatro, 11-point jam in total, and they have taken the lead, 28-17, and a team timeout will be called by Rainy City.
Well-placed timeout. I just want to point out Chinaski at that last moment immediately went for one of the blockers on Rainy City to try to prevent that, the thing that we were just talking about, the sort of solid blocking there. So they have, wow, they've been on a tear here. Dos Pocuatro has been on a scoring tier. So 4-4 and 11 past three jams. They've had the past four leads.
Yeah.
And so it is a really great timeout to be taken by Rainy City to sort of think through some things and readjust.
Right. And we're going to line back up here. Looks like jam number 8 about to come at you. Number 26, Tropico Mecanica, will be the jammer for Dos Pocuatro. Number 7, that is Mia, once again wearing the star for Rainy City. A quick check on the, we'll do that since we're about to start playing again. We will check our social media feed to see what we're talking about on hashtag Talk2WFTDA momentarily, but we're going to get jam number 8 going before we do that. Everybody congregating close to the inside line. And there's our whistle. And then Mia tried to go outside there.
It's just not
just
happening.
Got sucked back in.
It's
been that kind of afternoon.
It has been.
Tropico Mecanica up front working on the Rainy City defense. Multiplayer block called in the back pack for Dos Pocuatro. That's number 03, Demis. And once again, we are right back where we usually are. Turn one and nobody going anywhere. Direction of gameplay penalty assessed in the front pack to number 39 for Rainy City. 38, I'm sorry, Blondie. We do have a lead at Jammer, Tropical Mechanica.
But also out of the pack is Mia.
So Tropical Mechanica trying to race to the front of the pack as quickly as possible. Looks back, sees Mia coming, but not quite there. Now calls it off. Gets the four-point pass, does Tropical Mechanica. And that will extend the lead now for Dos Por Cuatro, 32-17. Do a very, very quick Twitter lineup.
So I'll tell you, while you're looking at Twitter, I'm going to tell you about Powerdyne plates and skate products. They are cutting-edge designs and cutting-edge performance.
Our friend Scarman the Chuck's tweeting, this front of the pack one-on-one blocking from Rainy City has me breathless.
Mm-hmm. It's
agreed.
Yes.
Agreed, Hutz.
Totally
agreed.
On board with that comment.
Here we go, Jammer. Number nine, that is Loba, where the star for Dos Por Cuatro, Ferry Quake, is the Rainy City Jammer. Loba tries to go out through the middle, but Rainy City shutting that door quickly. Multiplayer block assessed in the pack to Rainy City's pivot. And Loba is through, and Loba is lead Jammer.
Yes, Dos Por Cuatro has found a little wind beneath their wings.
They found some momentum that they're trying to keep drawing right here as Loba
really
now on a scoring pass.
Yes.
And a pack now sitting pretty much almost right in the middle of turns one and two. Very quick high-stepping through the inside for her initial pass. Loba says we're done.
So I think that's 8 men in the box.
So 4 points, yeah. Oh, well, yeah, 4 points awarded there to Dos Por Cuatro. Nice on the replay. Look at Loba going to the outside.
Boom.
And just took that outside lap and just got around the block of Blondie there for the pass.
So I just want to point out, Lizzie Aitman's been a presence on the track, as I said before. Right now, we're 13 minutes left in the first half. She's sitting on 5 penalties right
now.
Wow,
that's how tough this game has been defensively.
Yes.
And looks like Lawrence Walfield is through on the outside, lead Jammer for Rainy City. And a star pass by Dos Por Cuatro. Looks like number 45, Maki Lombera, is going to be the new Jammer.
That is.
And Jammer will be called by Rainy City. 2 points picked up, though.
Great strategy. You don't get out, immediately pass.
Exactly.
Right? That is a great strategy.
So your score now 36-19 in favor of Dos Por Cuatro. Clock is at 12 minutes, 30 seconds in the first period. Lining up now for jam number 11. And again, we have the battle of the sevens behind that jammer line. Rasho is the jammer for Dos Por Cuatro, Mia for Rainy City.
Oh. Sorry for the sound effects. Sometimes.
Rasho took off like a rocket through that pack, and lead Jammer was picked up rather quickly for Dos Por Cuatro.
So Rainey got that one lead and out of the previous six.
Yeah.
And then Dos Por Cuatro is dominating again in lead.
Yes, Jam is called. They got 1 point on that, did Dos Por Cuatro. So 37-19. And lining up their next jam will be number 9, Loba, jamming for Dos Por Cuatro. 81 is Fairy Quake for Rainy City. A little bit of last-second shuffling there by Rainy before the jam whistle blows. And Loba outside lane, almost totally wide open. She does get through this time, though, and makes lead.
Yes.
But that inside outside lane was a wide open pass.
You cannot leave it.
When we were sitting, I could look right down and see where Loba was going. Fairy Quake is through for her initial. And Loba calls off the jam, but gets 3 points.
I want to tell you a little bit about Derby Without Borders. It is a charity project dedicated to smashing the barriers of accessibility to roller derby around the world by providing leagues with coaching, support, and equipment. That's derbywithoutborders.org.
Our friends at Madison Roller Derby watching saying, I have decided that both these teams should be going to Montreal. WFTDA, can you pretty please make that happen? I have no pull in this, but I will at least –
support you also.
I support this. I will make the ask. I can't promise anything.
Right. Pretty please, though. It was a pretty please.
I know. That helps. Jam 13 underway. Lawrence Swaffield is the jammer for Rainy City. Tropical Mechanica is the jammer for Dos Por Cuatro. And once again, we are hanging out at the pivot line party. Everybody wants to be there. And we're all the way over here.
It is the best party.
Apparently so. It's been a party all weekend long.
Yes.
And through the pack, Tropical Mechanica dances
nice
through.
Yeah, that was lovely.
Lead jammer goes to Dos Por Cuatro. Swaffield still getting mired in the back wall set up by Dos Por Cuatro. Meanwhile, Tropical Mechanica to the inside looking for an avenue.
That was the best star pass. So when you go back to look at your video review, notice how Swaffield didn't stop pushing on the pack to let everybody know that she had actually given the star away.
That was very
nicely done.
For those on the audio feed, sorry you didn't see it.
Sorry.
Go back and watch the archives later.
Please
and you
go
will
watch
see
the
it.
Archives, those of you listening on
so
audio.
We did mention star pass by Rainy City to Lily Gaskell. But Lily Gaskell is being swamped this pack.
It was a beautiful star pass.
It was, but she's not able to go anywhere.
Immediately, Dos Por Cuatro just... Yeah.
They saw it, they sniffed it out, and they just locked it down. Now the pack moving through turn one, almost into turn two. Lily Gaskell having their reset. Still doesn't have the star cap on, but has it in hand. Meanwhile, Tropical Mechanica resets. Flying over the turn one apex.
Made it. Oh.
Wow.
Made it onto the track. That
Tropical
was
Mechanica went to the sky, landed it, and took the 4 points with her. And the jam times out.
Yeah.
No points on that last pass, but only four
one,
points picked up.
One scoring pass. Like so. Much energy expended here between the jammer and pivot line.
And here's our replay. Watch Tropical Mechanica right here, hopping over the apex.
Oh, look how high
got
in the air. It's just
angle.
Amazing.
Watch her feet, the way they landed, just barely getting inside.
Get in. Yeah.
I mean, that was such great placement of the skates by Tropical Mechanica.
Jumped over the hips of that blocker, just over the hips.
That was a great
amazing.
Angle on it, too. Great,
Gosh.
Great camera angle.
No, great.
44-19 is your score. We head now into jam number 14. Luluzon jamming for Dos Por Cuatro. Mia is the jammer for Rainy City. Again, we can't say this enough. The defense is just showing off right here. Mia trying to edge the outside, but Dos Por Cuatro, again, lining up that brace and just did not let her through. Luluzon now working at the front. Oh. Rainy City's wall trying to hold her back as well, but she's sledding them forward.
You've got the defense coming back to try to break up that tripod, and it just doesn't land. There's just not a lot of purchase there.
And we do get lead jammer. Luluzon is through. See, as a blocker, it kind of makes you think, like, hey, what do I do? Do I block the jammer? Do I go back and help my jammer out?
Now we have the defensive stance here.
Yeah. Mia is just
trying to get the defense up there.
Wow.
That was really nice.
Luluzon did a great job just laying the shoulder in the block on Mia. Jam ended up being called off after Mia got around. 4 points picked up by Dos Por Cuatro. 48-19 is now your score.
Just, we were talking about the one-on-one defense. Hey, the jammers also can do it.
Why not have the blockers have all the fun?
I know, right?
I'm going to block, too.
I'm going to also block because it's
why not?
Awesome.
Because I want to get them on a block party. It's a block party.
That
should have been the hashtag this weekend, block party.
Right.
I'm so late on things. Here we go. Jam 15. Lasho is the jammer for Dos Por Cuatro. Fairy Quake jamming for Rainy City. And Fairy Quake trying to just contort through that pack. That's all I can really say is just contort. And meanwhile, stuck in the back there, Lasho looking to just get out of the sad place because she is there.
And again, we are here at the pivot line.
Pivot line party. Block party, hashtag pivot line party, hashtag block party. If you could think of a creative hashtag that is tasteful for what we're doing right now, which it should be because you all are all great people out there, hashtag talk to WFTDA and give us your ideas. We'll Look them up later.
Yes.
And maybe shout a few out if they are deemed worthy.
Okay, again, we are a minute into the jam. We're at the first apex, y'all.
And a whistle blows in the pack of looking for the penalty. It's against Dos por Cuatro. It's a multiplayer block, which with these tight-knit balls blocking up, it's probably going to be a penalty de jure.
Oh.
Wow, very quick, just trying to lean in. Look at this.
Doing with the hands behind the back. Oh, one hand.
Very quick has to be a professional twister player.
Yes, and that was a little dance move by Lily Gaskell.
If I'm signing up a breakdance team, I am putting Fairy Quick on it. She has been so just bendy in getting knocked out and keeping balance all weekend long, and there's another example of it there. Does pick up lead jammer, now looking for points. Getting some help now from Lily Gaskell.
Gaskell just grabbed a hold of her wrist and was like, I'm going to pull you in. Pull you in, baby. Let's do this.
Whistle blows in the pack. A forearm penalty assessed to Rainy City. Goes against Stopless. And the jam comes to an end. Looks like all 4 points picked up by Rainy. So 48-23.
Let's see
now.
If we get this.
And here's your audition for Twister.
There's one hand down, but she pulls it back in.
Wow. Oh. Left hand red.
And then there's the pull off. Left skate like, green. I'm going to just pull you through. That's how that works.
Left skate green, right hand red.
Oh.
I'm telling you, he's got a future there. Here we go. Jam 16. Loba is a jammer for Dos por Cuatro. Ducky is the Rainy City jammer.
I imagine they're going to have to rotate in some other people to give some rest to some of their regular jammer rotations.
Ducky was...
both teams.
Yeah, Ducky was hot stepping on the outside. He missed it there on the outside of turn one, but ends up getting recycled back to the behind the pivot line. But yeah, like you're saying, these players have got to be getting worn out so far.
I don't know where they find this energy. I don't.
Limitless energy. If only I had that in my current age. Again, just... leaning in. Ducky tries to shift out, but once again gets right back into it. Same thing up front there for Loba.
Just the whole, and then they get the two pieces of the pack get mushed together, and then it's just a body's moving around.
The penalty box is now personless. And the pack moves around a little bit more. Turn two. We have action up front there. Loba still trying to work on those Rainy City blockers. All four of them now keying in on Loba.
I would like to see the average time it takes us to get to turn two. If anybody's out there in Twitterverse and wants to tell us what the average time it takes to get to turn two.
Any NSOs not working this weekend, grab your stopwatch and do some timing for us, and we'd love to hear the result on that.
I mean, because... 33 seconds left in the jam.
And up front, Loba. Loba almost threw on the outside, but not quite.
Rainy City just going to hang out right there. And
Ducky is still back there, too. I mean, nobody's going anywhere. If we can award tournament MVPs, can we just give it to, like, every blocker in this whole tournament? Because I feel like they all earned it.
MVP blockers are all of you.
Right. MVP blockers, every blocker here. Because you've all been putting on MVP performances.
Yes.
Jam times out.
Oh, the jam times.
No points and no lead jammer.
Wow.
That is the first time that's happened tonight.
It is the first time that's happened.
It may not be the last the way we keep going here, Rippy. I mean, that was just an intense.
Oh, here's a nice shot of coming up the line.
Wow.
Dance. Boom.
I said Ducky just has those fleet feet.
Oh.
Watch that. Watched and she went out right there. Just barely at the edge.
Gosh.
I wish I had those fleet of feet.
I wish I had that awareness.
Well, speaking of fleet
of
feet.
Of life in general.
Mia has fleet feet right now, skating through the lead jammer for Rainy City. Meanwhile, Tropical Mechanica still working in the pack for Dos por Cuatro. Mia just has somewhere to be and is not here. She's trying to move forward.
A very bumpy jammer.
Right.
Like, just jumped up the cover.
And whistle blows, high block penalty assessed to Mia.
Oh.
So that means a power jam for Dos por Cuatro. Tropical Mechanica working in the back, trying to hand the star off. She does star pass completed to Maki Lombera. So the pack awaiting Maki Lombera in... cheer number one. Oh, and big hit there.
My goodness.
Lily Gaskell just put a hit there on Lombetta.
Fully, I mean, the height difference, you know, there could be a danger of blocking in the wrong place or blocking in the wrong position, but that was clean.
But then once again, everybody is in the apex of one and two, but Mia is back out into the fray and dodges the nice dodge block. That block from Tropical Mechanica gets the 4 points. Does Mia 4 points also picked up by Maki Lombetta? So now we're moving.
Yes, and since we did have that penalty, we will and the star pass also. We won't have a lead.
I believe a back block penalty assessed to Lily Gaskell. Mia knocked to the infield, going to reset quickly in turn three, but here comes Maki Lombetta. And again, now we're showing off the defense for everybody hanging out by turn three. Our fan zone friends are getting
finally,
a nice, lovely
turn three
shot
you got to see.
Right. Our fan zone here getting a nice upfront view of that.
A couple of nice moves by Penny Block there. Awareness that Dos Porquatro jammer's coming in. Just got a hip on her. Just got her right into the infield. That was beautiful.
Looks like 11-point jam to 8 in favor of Dos Porquatro. That will be our halftime score. Ribby Longstocking, 59-31.
I'm tired.
I've got to take a breath here because that was tough. Here's our replay. Check out the replay.
Look at that.
And look at Mia just slice through the middle of that pack to get through. That was her lead jam, her initial jam run for lead. But wow, that was an impressive
really
first half, as we would have figured. Mm-hmm. Nothing less expected in a bronze medal game of a playoff.
Indeed, yes, at this level. But it's every bit of exciting as we thought it would be.
Oh, yeah, and we still have a whole half to go. That's the best part. So we're going to be right back with our second half. Be sure to join us right here for Winston-Salem, our bronze medal game here at WFTDA.TV. All right, welcome back. And Rippy Longstocking, that was an exciting first half to our bronze medal game.
Yes.
I mean, it's just, how do we describe that other than exciting?
I'm exhausted after watching the first half.
I had to go take a nap at halftime. It was that exhausting.
We did have a very low number of jams there, only 17 that we ended up with. So let's do a little talking about these two teams. So we did look it up, by the way, giving a shout out to stats.wftda.com. It's a great place to go and look up features of different teams and when they played and the forecast for a game. By the way, the forecast for this game is 1 point differential.
So, I mean, it's not far off.
I think maybe it could happen. So they met once in 2018, in January 2018 in Manchester. So this will be the time that they're meeting here in 2019 at the playoffs. So that's pretty interesting to know about these two teams.
And that game result was Rainy City over Dos Porquatro, 132-126. So, I mean, close game.
Right.
1 point predictor. I mean, this is.
But But Dos Porquatro, you know, looking to bring out the win for sure this time.
And looking here at our jammer stats in the first half for Rainy City. Looks like we have our leading score is Fairy Quake with 18. Mia with 3. Lawrence Wafield with 2. For Dos Porquatro, leading a score is Luluzan with 16. Behind her, Tropical Mechanica with 12. And Rasho with 11. And, I mean, you see a lot of the lead jam percentages there, box trips. A lot of times, only 5 jammers in that rotation for Dos Porquatro. Rainy City putting in 6. I'm sure they won with the star pass, I believe, a couple times. Right. So, yeah.
And I think the story here really is that Dos Porquatro was able to keep Rainy City scoreless 12 times. 12 jams.
12 scoreless jams.
Yes.
And you saw a lot of those jams. Of course, we had that one jam where no lead jammer, no points scored.
Yes.
And here we go off again in the second half. Let's see what it brings to us. We have Luluzan wearing the star for Dos Porquatro. Fairy Quake is the Rainy City jammer. And once again, the defense is trying to set up shop now, but a little more frenetic action there in the pack.
Shout out to the fact that we're past turn one.
Yay. We've broken that milestone early here. All right, now in turn two, again, defense is settling in. Luluzan getting reset back into behind the Rainy City wall. And Fairy Quake at the front trying to get some help there from her pivot, Lily Gaskell. And nobody budging.
Lily Gaskell able to provide help, and yet Dos Por Cuatro is so able to just
their
find
rate of
one
reformation is insanely high.
Yes.
And now a little more movement. Now is we're right back to where we were, just a little bit further up the track. Heading into turn three, but nice work up front. Rainy City stopless serving as the brace for that two wall.
Oh, big hit by Penny Block.
Just took the impact from Chinosky and was able to just absorb it.
Throw back a little of her own.
It's a lot of kinetic energy just engaged right there.
Just.
And looks like a penalty in the back blocking the call. Oh, and it is going to be against Fairy Queen. So we will have
hurts
a power
my heart.
Jam.
We worked almost jam. All the way around the track.
Power jam now for Dos Por Cuatro. And a penalty assessed to the pivot for Dos Por Cuatro. That is Maki Lombera, direction of gameplay penalty. So two blockers light. We are moving through turn four. And one blocker and one jammer.
Yeah,
light,
one blocker. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
That's all right. There are two bodies in the penalty
two
box.
Two bodies in the box. One is a star on their helmet. One is a stripe on their helmet.
Right.
So a pivot is out and a jammer is out. No score on that jam, so there we go. Scoreless jams. Defense.
It is, I mean.
Yeah, defense wins the day, or wins the jam at least.
Wins.
Here's our replay right here. Check out the inside move. Oh. By Fairyquake. Getting knocked infield. But
and I think that, I'm not sure if that was when they called
it.
It
might have been
the
penalty,
her,
I believe.
Yeah.
So here we go. Power start for Dos Por Cuatro. Rasha is the jammer.
Oh, very quickly. Up that line.
Yeah, Rasha moving furiously through the pack, and lead jammer does go to Rasha. So now the pack trying to get settled in by the pivot line. Rasho in for a scoring pass. And body's hitting the ground, including the returning Fairyquake, but Rasho is through for four.
So Rainy, I think that's Rascal. I don't have a good view, but I think that's Rascal in the box for Rainy City. And that's the only person in the block at the moment.
And a penalty in the pack, I believe, is a position penalty assessed to Dos Por Cuatro. That will go against number 03, Temis. And the Rainy City side of the box empties out for now. And I should skating out of bounds penalty. Oh, against Rainy City. So Star has been passed by Rainy City to number 88, Banshee. And another penalty assessed now to Dos Por Cuatro.
Now Temis picked up that penalty just now. That is number six.
Number six. Yeah, we didn't get to talk about penalties coming out of the halftime. Each team had a player with five. Now we have one with six with Demis on her sixth penalty. For Rainy City, number 77, Liz Eatman is sitting on five. So of course,
but Demis has been sitting on five since the first five minutes of the first half. So.
So Temis now working on basically one more penalty to give before her evening will be done.
Yep.
Mia jamming for Rainy City. Number nine, Loba is the jammer for Dos Por Cuatro. And Mia is out front first for lead. Pack in turn one. Lily Gaskell trying to clear a path.
Oh,
Mia
nice.
Says, it's okay, I'll just hop over the apex and go.
Just beautiful.
Pack still just enamored with turn one. As Mia,
my goodness gracious.
Took a hit coming out of that low move. But just back up and right through the pack again for 4 points.
Wow, just really nice.
Multiplayer block call assessed in the pack against Rainy City. I believe that was against Faye Roberts.
Balance, I just am amazed.
And pack picking up some speed now, but there goes Loba. 4 points, but not to be outdone. Mia picks up four of her own. But Mia sitting on 12 points now as we roll. Loba with a nice shift to the outside. But she gets a track cut. Track cutting call was called against Loba. So Mia is now on the power jam. Direction of gameplay penalty assessed for Rainy City. 417, that is stopless. And jam will be called off after it looks like Mia's like, I think she's okay, but she's had to stop for a second and kind of a take
was
a, she needed a
lot
a second.
Of brutal brutality out there.
She needed a second there because that was a lot of action, a lot of physicality, and the penalty box was kind of swarming in and out. We will have a, looks like a power start for Rainey. Not quite yet, though, because we have a team timeout to be called by Dos Por Cuatro.
So have you tried the Adam Savant wheels? See what you've been missing.
I will do that. I will indeed do that. Adam Savant wheels are excellent skate wheels. Take a quick look at our Twitter. See what all you all are talking about at Talk to WFTDA. Looks like, here we go. It's had to do a quick refresher there, and I had a nice little animation pop up there. Here, Mary, a.k.a. Fred Whistley, coming in. Come on, Rainey, do it for hashtag jam time. Let's go a little bit further back here. Oh, this was a good one we saw during halftime. Salty Goddess at Liz Headrush. Grind.
That has been the story
name
of this game.
Yes.
Right?
You could add a few more eyes in there, yes, and it still really wouldn't kind of capture what it is. So it has been a grind.
As we head into this jam, let me remind you to check out derbywithoutborders.org to see how you can help support the growth of roller derby around the world. Remember to bring your donations to the 2019 playoffs and champs. We still have a couple of things to go here, so you can bring your donations there.
Seattle next weekend, and then, of course, champs in Montreal in November. Here we go, jam number four. Loba is the jammer for Dos Por Cuatro, coming out of the box against Mia.
And Loba is through.
Loba is through for lead. Mia trying to find her way through, but going back and forth.
Sorry.
Knocked to the outfield. Direction of gameplay penalty assessed against number 84, Persefone. And Mia does make her initial pass. Now it's Lobas putting it through the pack on a couple of hits, but just kept on pirouetting.
Amazing.
Woo, 4-point pass for Loba. Now Mia picking up four of her own. And Loba tries to swing around on the hips to the inside. And Mia going to get brought back via Chinaski. And penalty box empties. Jam is called. Looks like 1 point picked up for Rainy City, 3 for Dos Por Cuatro. Your score now 84-54, 30-point differential in favor of Dos Por Cuatro.
Not a huge one at all,
but as we see our replay right here, watch the footwork of Loba keeping it in bounds. Very nicely done. Like I said, another great camera angle catching the minutia of the action in this pack. And jam 5 is underway here. Fairy Quake jamming for Rainy City. That is Luluzon for Dos Por Cuatro.
This will definitely be one that I save in my YouTube to watch abundantly.
Lead jammer does go to Dos Por Cuatro. Also, my Topical Mechanica is the jammer. She is the lead jammer. Fairy Quake rolling around on her initial pass. Now eligible to score.
Coming in fast. And I think she might have. No,
she did not.
Okay.
She almost did. She was very close.
She
there,
was so close.
Topical Mechanica was able to call it off in time. 3 points for Dos Por Cuatro, 87 their score, 54 for Rainy City. We're at about 21 minutes and 45 seconds to go in the game, in our bronze medal game. Remember, the winner of this game will receive third place in our bracket and will punch their ticket to Montreal.
Yes. And as you said earlier, Pierre, this is so exciting because neither of these teams
first time
have done this. So
I love seeing a first-time team
really
make
exciting
it. Yes, it's exciting for everybody here, including these two teams.
Yes.
And off we go. Lauren Swalfield is the jammer for Rainy City. That is Luluzon wearing the star for Dos Por Cuatro.
Oh. When both defenses that are seriously great by themselves are all packed in together, there's no movement.
It's like a super, no, like a super defense. When two become one, super defense.
Super
forearm
defense.
Forearm penalty assist in the pack. Meanwhile, Lee Jammer does go to Luluzon.
Oh.
And a pack picking up a little bit of speed. Dos Por Cuatro trying to get out front. Rainey, nice work to waterfall right back in front of Luluzon.
They're going to have to drop back. That's
that is Blondie I see working up front there also, as well as number six, Rascal. Believe a penalty assessed in the pack, number 77, to Liz Yeatman.
That was such a fast star pass.
Yeah, jam was called. The star pass was made, but four-point jam in favor of Dos Pocuatro gives them 91-54 now for Rainy City.
Now, we do have two players sitting on six right now. We talked about Liz Yeatman.
Liz Yeatman, yeah, that was that penalty that she picked up was her sixth, yes.
Jameis. Camise, I guess that's.
Tamis, with six penalties. So
we had the team rehearse with us. So
we want to make sure we're getting everybody's names accurately, so we consult the sources. And lead jammer going to get picked up here by Mia for Rainy City. Jamming up against Rasha. And Rasha is passing the star to Persephone.
The first lead in three jams for Rainy.
And a four-point pickup there for Mia.
Oh,
track cutting call against Liz Yeatman. Sorry.
That was Lily Gaskell, not Liz Yeatman, because she would be out, right?
No. The penalty was against Lily Gaskell.
Right, there we go.
Apologies.
I was like, did we just lose the play?
No, that was me. That was on me. Apologies. And spinning through the pack, nice move by Persephone to pick up 4 points. And Mia was keeping an eye on Persephone and decided to call off the jam.
Yep.
Four points picked up by Rainey. That will give them 62. Dos Pocuatro at 95. 18:51 left on the period clock in the second period.
Check out this replay. Boom.
Just watch the movement from Mia swinging around.
Yes.
Able to complete the pass right there. And then one more edge block, skating through, just digging in.
Taking the momentum in the shoulder to spin herself around, right? Like
right.
From that hit.
Yeah.
Kinetic
energy, yeah. Loba is through, and Loba is lead jammer for Dos Pocuatro. Meanwhile, Ferryquake mired in the back of the pack.
Everybody circling back to help out.
Loba taking a spill to the infield, going to reset back behind Lily Gaskell. And here we are again. Walls and jammers going nowhere. But trying very, very hard. Now Lily Gaskell going to go try to go help out her jammer in the front. Mila Loba still just working around these Rainy City blockers, but nobody giving anything in quarter right here.
No.
Oh. So star pass has been made to Lily Gaskell for Rainy City. Jam is called. Looks like no points for Rainy City. Full 4-point pass for Dos Pocuatro. And they are now on the brink of 100, 99-62. Here's your replay. Watch Loba right here. Edges to the inside. And just, wow. That was incredible agility.
So the S1 Lifer helmet, best fit plus superior protection equals made for roller derby.
Yes, indeed.
Get a lifer, be a lifer.
All right, here we go. Tropical Mechanica is through.
Oh, my goodness.
Tropical Mechanica picked up lead, but Ducky had some action getting through that pack right there for her initial. A blocker, a piece in the penalty box.
That's the first time Ducky has had this half, yeah. So. Yeah. Probably just needed some fresh legs out there because that is tough work.
And it seems to be working so far. 4 points picked up for Rainy City. A whistle blows in the pack looking for the penalty. It looks like it's against Dos Pocuatro.
Oh. And now look at that.
Jammer play against Jammer.
Tropical Mechanica wants, and, a little,
ooh,
wants a little defensive stuff nice.
Right. Ducky takes the bump off of Tropical Mechanica, but Mechanica able to break through and picks up the 4-point pass. The defense is contagious.
It's like, you know, I want to do some of this stuff.
I'm going to go walk and just start blocking people randomly.
I don't want to just sit here in this wall. I would like to hit people.
Right.
So.
Like, I want to get in on
the
fun.
Let me just get out of there.
And again, just locking these jammers down. Ducky leaning on that back wall from Dos Pocuatro. Tropical Mechanica kind of pinned in the inside. Now shoved to the infield.
Oh, just no movement
and
here.
McGanica says we're going to call
it. We're going to call it, yep.
And looks like a four-point pass for Rainey. 2 points picked up by Dos Pocuatro. And that will give us a score now of 105 for Dos Pocuatro. Rainey City at 70. Team timeout going to be called here by Rainey City, freezing the clock at 15:31.
Lock down the competition with the Super Bowl Toe Stop by Gumball. Speaking of toe stops, might need to replace some after this game. Gumball, most trusted toe stop in Derby.
There are going to be a lot of skaters looking for new toe stops after this weekend because we just keep talking about it because we have to. I mean, the defense in this game and all weekend has been tremendous.
It really has.
I mean, credit to all of these teams here this weekend. I mean, regardless of where they finish, their defenses have been insanely strong.
Yes. It has been. So let me thank some people. As I mentioned earlier, we were looking at stats.wftda.com, and I certainly would like to give a shout-out to that because it's a great resource where you follow along with live game updates and matchups at stats.wftda.com. You can forecast the game results, keep up with who's playing who when, and see how the playoffs affect live rankings. So this stuff goes in quickly at all at stats.wftda.com.
Yes, indeed. Here we go. Jam at number 10 here. Mia is the Rainy City Jammer being opposed by Luluzan for Dos Pocuatro. Whistle blows, forearm penalty in the jammer against Mia. That's going to get Dos Pocuatro a power jam. And Lee Jammer has been awarded to Luluzan. Contact penalty, legal contact against Rainy City. And Luluzan now working on the power jam. As it gets through, officially makes the completed pass, but still did earn Lee Jammer.
So I'd like to point out that Mia has actually jammed 5 of the last 10. We're in jammed 10.
She has.
So I just don't even know where she's getting.
No.
She must have some source of energy that I am well unaware of.
We need to find and harness and bottle it.
Yeah. So we're only on jam 10, 5. 50% of those jams have been Mia.
So 4-0 jam right now in favor of Dos Pocuatro. Jam is going to be called. Looking for additional points. Not seeing any, so it looks like it might still be a 4-0 jam. That'll give Dos Pocuatro 109 at Rainy City at 70. And we are at about 13 minutes and 57 seconds to go in the game. Remember, following this game will be our gold medal game, Texas versus Angel City.
Another good one.
Another great game.
It's so fun to watch.
Every game this weekend really has been outstanding, regardless of where the scoreboard stood.
Yes.
Here we go. Fairy Quake is jamming for Rainy City. That is Racho for Dos Pocuatro. And Racho getting almost moved backwards, not by choice. Fairy Quake.
It was almost like, ta-da!
Ta-da! I did it. I got
made it.
Jammer.
I have gotten
I don't know,
of that pack.
Breaking through a pack in this jam,
yes.
If you can make that as a jammer,
I mean,
you should kind of celebrate.
I would celebrate.
That, right?
I just can't imagine a better feeling.
That deserves that a celebration. And 4 points there for Fairy Quake. As Dos Pocuatro loses a blocker to the penalty box.
So Gaskell is out there ready to just bump through that tripod, opening up a lane. That was really great work and great timing on opening up the lane, too.
Now everybody back in the 1-2 apex area. And looks like a star pass has been completed by Dos Pocuatro. New jammer will be Maki Lombera. But unable to capitalize as the jam is called. 2 additional points for Rainy City. So a 10-point jam in total for Rainy gives them 80. Dos Pocuatro at 113, 12 minutes and 25 seconds to go. And our replay here with Fairy Quake.
Woo.
Just edges to the outside and just
see,
skates through and then watch. Hello! I did it.
So yeah, she was just holding her balance, but it looked very ta-da.
We're gonna say it looked like a ta-da, but we all know she was.
And
trying
you know
to
what?
Maintain.
If it was a ta-da, I feel like it was a good looking one.
It was a balancing ta-da.
It was.
Team timeout called by Dos Pocuatro, freezing the clock at 12 minutes and 9 seconds to go. Bronze medal game, and we have seen quite a show.
Yes.
We still have 12 minutes to go.
So let me tell you about Rydell Skates, because I feel like I should.
Please do.
Shout out to Rydell Skates, proud sponsor of the 2019 WFTDA playoffs and championships. So sponsoring all of the playoff portions and then the one in Montreal. So I want to give a shout out to them. Rydell.com. It's Riedell.com.
And I get on the replay, checking out Fairy Quake, edging on the outside, then running on those toe stops to get through. Just such a graceful and deliberate jammer is Fairy Quake. Looking at jammer stats really quickly here. 42 points for Mia for Rainy City. Fairy Quake with 18. Meanwhile, for Dos Pocuatro, we have Luluzan with 28. Rasho with 19. Loba with 29 leading the way.
And you see there the quick look at the penalties. We've got still the two players with six. Everybody else kind of, you know, there's a couple of people with four, but most people are keeping it pretty clean.
No other real danger zone situations as
just
we go.
Just those two.
Here we go. Jam 12. Loba out quickly for Lee Jammer and a track cut being assessed in the pack to Rainy City, but Loba is lead. And Loba now takes a big hit in the back of that pack. And a multiplayer block going to be caught against Penny Block.
I'm not
Rainy
sure.
City.
Okay, just like there wasn't enough room for Penny Block in there, but then Gaskell stood up. So we do have a seat available, but that leaves not many people.
No, direction of gameplay caught against Chinoski. So, no room at the end there for blocker-wise for Rainy City at the moment. And Loba is through for 4 points. Pack coming through turn number three. Mia trying to dance that line on the inside. Loba flies through.
Nice.
Comes in kind of hot. Slides out of bounds. So
that was stopless.
That was
stopless.
Yeah. All right. Here we go. Lining up again here with these walls. Just trying to set up shop. Mia with the star cover off her helmet. And Dos Pocuatro trying hard to get their jammer through. Maki Lambera tried to work up front to free Loba, but unable to do so. Is now Faye Roberts going to draw back all the way to turn two exit.
So it looks like Lily Gaskell does have the star.
I believe she does, yes. Yep. She does have the star, I believe, in hand. It's not on her helmet yet.
My goodness.
And getting some help by her, the former jammer, Mia, trying to spring the new jammer, Lily Gaskell.
I think Lily Gaskell had to move backwards a little bit to grab the star, right? And so that pack was able to just immediately
direction
right
of gameplay penalty assessed to Mia.
Oh.
And Lily Gaskell into a brief, a quick halt there, but able to reset back in turn three. Jam is called. 4 points go to Dos Pocuatro. 12-point jam in total gives them 125. Rainy City, a scoreless jam there. 80 is their score. 10 minutes in to go in the game.
So we were bragging on some of the jammers before, so let me give a shout-out to Loba, who has led 3 out of 4 of the jams that she's taken this half. So just to give a little shout-out to some other folks, too. Doing a great job. Everybody's on here. I wish I could say a lot of different things.
Oh, yes. And off we go, Jam 13. Fairy Quake is the Rainy City jammer. Tropical Mechanica is the Dos Pocuatro jammer. And nobody going anywhere. Fairy Quake trying to edge the inside. Tropical Mechanica now making some headway forward. Two Rainy City blockers in her path. And now just one, now none, as Lee Jammer goes to Tropical Mechanica after the multiplayer block penalty basically sprung her from that wall situation.
So a blocker apiece in the box right now.
Yes.
So and we're even on the track.
Yes, and 4 points up in the air for Tropical Mechanica, who calls it off.
I think, Fairy Quake was able to put some on the board.
For points for Rainy City, two for Fairy Quake.
Nice.
So 4-3 points, I'm sorry. 4-3 jam in favor of Dos Pocuatro. So 129-83 is your score. Quick check on Twitter. Our buddy Lightning Slim. Bronze games are always a treat. Slim, you are correct.
Indeed.
Can confirm. All right, here we go. Lauren Swaffield is the Rainy City Jammer. Swaffield through for lead. And meanwhile, Louison in the back takes the star cover off. Hands it off now to Amaki Lombetta on the star pass. And Swaffield on the outside swings wide. It takes the turn, completes the pass for four. And Pack now outside of turn number two. Swaffield comes back on the approach. Goes outside. Now back to the middle. Meanwhile, Mackie Lombetta in the back. And a whistle blows in the pack. Penalty against Rainy City. Meanwhile, Mackie Lombetta furiously up front with Blondie.
More of that one-on-one.
Yeah.
So important.
So Mackie Lombetta picks up the 4 points. And Jam is going to be called two more for Rainy City. So a 6-4 Jam in favor of Rainy. And it's like a team timeout going to be called by Rainy City, freezing our game clock now at 7 minutes and 16 seconds.
So the S1 Lifer visor helmet, next level protection. And I do want to point out something, PR, that happened in that last Jam.
Yes.
So you saw that Damiz got a penalty. Mm-hmm. That's 7.
That's 7. That means her evening is done.
You know, it just kind of breaks my heart because I know that these teams work so hard to get to this, and they're you know, pumped up. And so I know that that's disappointing, but a presence that certainly will be missed by the teammates. But
definitely.
Sorry that had to happen, but we'll see her sitting up in the stands right behind her team to cheer them on.
And a quick read on our Twitter again, so I'm going to go ahead and do this. Meg Fenway, I have not had a single tweet read on the broadcast this weekend, and that is a first. Wow. That now changes, Fenway. You're welcome.
Oh, here's your favorite. 2-7.
7-7. The lucky jam, as I like to call it. That is number 7, of course, Horacio for Dos Por Cuatro. And Mia is the number 7 for Rainy City. And Rasho in the back trying to move forward. Oh, penalty against Mia.
High block.
High block, I believe, was the call. Now power jam and lead jam for Dos Por Cuatro as Rasho is through for lead. So a good opportunity here for Dos Por Cuatro to make it a little bit further. It took a quick hit, but right back up. And Rasho looking now for a scoring pass. But once again, Rainy setting up that brace two wall, almost a rolling tripod, rotating tripod.
So Mia standing right there.
Now breaking it up. Last block of the beat was Banshee. Got by 4 points there for Rasho.
We are starting to see the penalties add up here.
And there's another one just as you said that. Another penalty whistle blows. Didn't see the hand signal, but it is a blocker for Dos Por Cuatro. Taking a seat in the penalty box is number 14. Mandarina. Two more points there for Dos Por Cuatro.
In the past three jams, we've had three additional players move to 5 penalties. And so we're seeing this.
Yep.
I mean, sure, we're now under 6 minutes.
Yes.
Time to throw your all in there, but
that's
maybe
it.
Cleanly.
And check out the replay here. Nice work getting through the middle of that pack on the last jam as we line up here for the next jam. Fairy Quake for Rainy City is the jammer. Loba is the Dos Por Cuatro jammer. And Fairy Quake through for lead for Rainy City. Loba is out as well for her initial.
The pack. This is the fastest we've seen the pack all weekend,
right?
PR.
This is.
Can't believe it.
And a whistle blows. It looks like a low block penalty assessed to number 11, Faye Roberts for Rainy City. And there's almost a sustained pack speed for a while.
And then they collapse right there at the apex, ready for Loba to come in.
Right, very quick to complete the four-point pass prior. And apex jump not quite completed. Penalty assessed. Illegal contact to Fairy Quake. So power jam for Dos por Cuatro.
Really wanted her to land that. I felt it in my soul.
And Loba moves around through turns three and four, picks up the four-point pass. Got opportunity here to extend that lead now as it's even 4-4 jam as we roll. Loba trying to change that and gets around to the outside and does so for another 4 points.
So really taking advantage of 50 seconds left, 46 seconds left on the jam clock.
And Loba now approaching the Rainy City blockers. Oh, was getting some help for a second there from Maki Lombetta, who took a spill. Now going to serve as a bridge. And now backing up to the front, the back wall for Dos por Cuatro.
As we saw earlier, some blockers pushing the jammer forward. We just saw Fairyquake take a blocker.
Fairyquake.
And use that too. It works both ways.
All right.
You can do it.
So 4 points picked up by Loba. Again, 4 points also for Fairyquake. And now both jammers. Oh, Fairyquake striding through the apex.
I'm concerned about that.
A track cutting penalty, I believe, says to the pivot, Maki Lombetta.
Okay.
So there we go. 13-9 jam in favor of Dos por Cuatro. Gives them 152. Rainy 98. 3 minutes, 24 seconds to go. 22 now. As the time keeps moving.
Check out AdamSkates.com for the latest in derby gear. That's AtomSkates.com.
Wow. Yes. Look at the control by Fairyquake. Get through on the apex there. Last jam. Off we go here. Lawrence Swaffield is the Rainy City jammer against Tropico Mecanica for
Look at that.
Cuatro.
Swaffield.
Wow.
Just rocketing up the outside. That was amazing.
So a lead jammer does go to Rainy City. Tropical Mecanica took off the star.
Oh,
pirouetting through the pack.
Beautiful.
And Swaffield, sliding out of turn number two. Now right back up and into the infield. Going to reset back in turn two as the jam is called.
4-0 to
Rainy City. Yes, Rainy City wins that jam 4-0.
It's really interesting that we've seen the slow pack this whole entire game between the jammer and pivot line. But just to see when they get some speed on them, how agile and
speaking of agile,
I can't even find the words. The words are having a hard time. how when they go fast, they are also as graceful. There we go. I got some words.
You got
there
it.
We go.
All right. Luluzon jamming for Dos por Cuatro against Fairyquake once again for Rainy City. And Fairyquake going to reset back in turn one. Meanwhile, Luluzon trapped behind the Rainy City defense. Whistle blows in the pack. Multiplayer block on Penny Block. And another penalty. Lee Jammer goes. It's going to go to Dos por Cuatro.
So, yes.
Oh, Rainy City.
Look at this. We've got a train of blockers. We're not going to have room.
There's only two seats in that box. So one's got to stand up. 4 points there, picked up by Luluzon. Looking for more.
Until we have a space.
We have one blocker out there for Rainy City at the moment. Number 417, Stopless.
Stopless, you are the wall.
And a penalty assessed to the pivot. Oh, also two more penalties now for Dos por Cuatro. So penalties abounding in this jam as well.
Oh, it looks like Fairyquake got a little hit maybe there too. He's playing defense because noticing that she just has the one blocker.
Now getting some reinforcements now as Penny Block and Lily Gasker return from the penalty
Everybody
box.
Everybody coming back, okay.
4 points picked up in that last pass. Luluzon now working on 12 points. Trying to add a few more. And initial pass has been completed by Fairyquake, who hops into the inside.
That was really fast.
Just hopped. Made a hop.
Sideways down the line. It's going to go sideways.
And through on the inside, Luluzon picks up the 4 points. Fairyquake. Reset to the inside.
Cheering here
right
in the venue. It's exciting.
And Luluzon spinning through the outside in turn two for 4 points.
So
and
our
that jam comes to an end. We are not done. Rainy City trying to call their official review, I believe. I believe they got it. Razor. 3 points for Rainey on that last pass. 4 for Dos Por Cuatro. The score as it stands right now, 172 Dos Por Cuatro, 109 mm-hmm. for Rainey City.
So Dos Por Cuatro hanging out there, the whole bench together, just trying to see. So an official review being used as a timeout.
With one second.
1 second so we're gonna left get, on the clock.
We're going to get one more jam in this exciting, just action-packed bronze medal game. You can just tell how bad these two teams want to get that bronze medal. So the high score of the game there, 20-point jam for Dos Por Cuatro. That was the highest
score
jam of the game.
That was the highest score jam of the game. Yes. And as we said earlier, very slow jams there for most of the game, a majority of the game.
Slow
jams. Slow jams. I know, like, slow jams. Slow jam Sunday.
What better way to cap this awesome game with the Battle of Sevens once again?
Right.
We have Racho jamming for Rainy City. Mia for Dos Por Cuatro. Rainy City 7 is Mia.
And everybody just piled in.
Yeah. Period clock has expired. We are on jam time.
On slow jam time.
Slow jam time, because we are slow jamming it right now. Penalty assessed in the pack to Dos Por Cuatro's pivot.
And high a block. Penalty assessed. Oh, no.
High block to Mia. So power jam for Dos Por Cuatro. Lead jam for Dos Por Cuatro.
So not interested in calling. Looks at the bench. Yeah, there we go. Should I call it? Yeah.
Yep. Racho calls it off.
Rippy,
we have an unofficial final. Rainy City 109. Dos Por Cuatro 172. So when the score is made official, everything was standing. Looks like Dos Por Cuatro will be making their first trip to championships.
Yes, indeed.
And also be the first South American team to play at champs.
Amazing.
Amazing finish to an outstanding
game. Love to have as many comments as we can.
Yes, outstanding game.
Yes.
And there's your whistle. We are final.
That is it. That
your
is the final score.
Final score. Dos Por Cuatro 172, Rainy City 109, and as we said, Rainy City will take the bronze medal. They will make the trip to champs, their first time going, and a first time for a South American team to make it to champs. Congratulations to Dos Por Cuatro.
Congratulations. Well earned. Well earned.
And nothing to hang their head on by Rainy City.
Oh,
they fought. This game is so hard-paced. Such good defense. I mean, it was just impressive of both sides. Rainy City had an impressive run through this playoff.
Really, I mean, it's been a pleasure to watch all of these teams this weekend. As we wrap up here, you see the final score on your screen. You see some chanting from all of our teams. I'd like to say the penalty tracker, we had everybody just... Nothing. Okay, let me start over. Let me start a new sentence because I got excited and then it went away. So we didn't have many people. We had 2 people in penalty trouble, one from each team. We came into the second half. We do have a lot more penalties, but that just shows you how just how much energy and how much they were giving out on the track. We did have another foul out right at the very last jam. Mm-hmm. That was number 11, Faye Roberts on Rainy City. But you can see here that we have several people with 5, several people with 6.
Yeah.
Across the board. No one team was extreme.
In a defensive game like this, you got to think penalties are going to be heavy.
Yes.
Because of just the work going on in these packs. I mean, it kind of breeds penalties in the action. Looking at our final tallies for scores, top scoring jammer for Dos Por Cuatro is Lulazan with, no, sorry, it's Loba. 54 points. Lulazan with 48. Tropico Mecanica and Rajo both finish with 25. For Rainy City, leading jammer Mia, Fairyquake, has 47 points. 42
amazing.
By Mia, so they had the bulk majority of Rainy
absolutely.
City scoring.
Rainy City.
Lawrence Swathfield with 12. And again, everybody's lining up now in a great sportswomanship here for Rainy City. Going to give the high fives first to Dos Por Cuatro in a very, very friendly matchup here.
Right.
As defensive as it was, everybody excited.
Everybody is clapping and cheering here in the venue.
As they should be.
Yes. I clapped too, not that they can hear me here on the stream, but that's okay. I'm clapping.
Sure anyway. We are clapping, trust
yes.
me.
Yes.
And also, Rainy City, as we said.
Yes.
Tough performance.
Absolutely.
Great, great performance by both of these teams.
Outstanding.
Somebody
to
had to win. Somebody, unfortunately, was going to come up short in this. So, again, Dos Pocuatro punching that ticket to Montreal to champs. And an impressive, impressive victory.
So excited for them.
Yeah. So what we see right here, just a great show of respect by both of these teams.
Lots of hugs on Dos Pocuatro, of course.
We are just breathless and almost wordless as announcers. That's a whole lot to say. We're going to wait shortly for our post-game interview. Since it's play sec, we'll be interviewing somebody. So we're going to... take a second. So,
let's talk some more about things.
We had a little bit earlier. I'm going to go ahead and show off what's going to be coming up here.
Look at that.
Next, gold medal, silver medal. The next game coming up, Texas and Angel City.
That'll be really good.
Yeah, they're both already going to champs, but who's going to go with the higher seed? Texas came in as the number one seed, Angel as the number two seed. So, as far as chalk went, they chalked out to the championship game. But one of them will be the top seed out of this bracket. One will be the lowest seed out of this bracket. And then, well, of course, the third seed will be Dos Pocuatro.
Yes.
So we're going to have an exciting time watching that next game and figuring out who will take home the gold and the silver.
Right.
Once again, before we toss it to Sissy in a second, big thank you and shout out to our host league, Greensboro Roller Derby.
Really done amazing job.
Yes, an impressive weekend so far. One game to go.
Mm-hmm.
And they have been the most excellent and gracious of hosts.
I love them. I'm from this area.
Okay. You have a love for them, and I do now as well.
I love them anyway. So now everyone gets to see how much I love them and why I love them as much as I do, because they're just so hospitable and they're so willing to help out. The venue has been comfortable and beautiful and well kept.
Yes.
And they have coffee every morning, so let me just put that right on out there that they have just made me happy. That's what I need to make myself happy.
And I also want to give props to our awesome producer, Tool Time, for feeding us some great information. You can't see him on camera, but he's ready. You can pop his head in if you want to.
Come in.
Come on, Tool
there
Time. Hi.
There's Tool Time.
Hi, Tool Time. And we want to thank you for all the great work you helped us out with here in this game. It looks like...
If we sounded really smart, it's because...
It's because of Tool Time, because, I mean, it's not me. I mean, more rippy than me with the smarts, but, you know... So it looks like we are going to have our post-game interview coming up shortly with a few different skaters from Dos Pocuatro.
Looks like I'm very excited to hear this post-game interview because, of course, Sissy's post-game is very good at giving post-game interviews. And then also we get to hear from this team that gets to travel to Canada.
All right. So we're going to go ahead and toss it down to Sissy's Playsec with our Dos Pocuatro team, and we'll see you in a few.
With the amazing winners, Dos Pocuatro.
Hi, how are you?
Hi. How are y'all feeling after that game?
We still can't believe it. We worked so hard for this. We had a lot of obstacles, of money. We don't have a coach. We have a lot of trouble trying to come here. So we still can't believe all of this.
Yeah, I mean, it's amazing. Like, in the best circumstances, leagues have the support and they don't have to travel very far. And y'all are having to overcome so much just to even get to this point. And now, what is it going to be like? You're going to go to champs in Montreal.
Yeah. It's very difficult for us.
Yes.
We need, please, if someone wants to help us, sponsors of any kind of help, we will really appreciate it. Because we need all of the help of the world.
Y agradecerle a todos por el apoyo que nos dieron estos días.
We want to thank all the people here that have been so kind to us, all the Greensboro League. They've done all for us. So we want to thank them.
So, it's a lot. You're feeling a lot of emotions, obviously. This game just happened. What are you feeling?
Wow.
La verdad que todo el trabajo que hicimos valió la pena. Todo el esfuerzo que hicimos desde que nos empezamos con el Roller Derby, este fue el objetivo máximo. y realmente estar cumpliéndolo juntas, pese a todas las cosas que tenemos en contra, estamos orgullosas y agradecidas por todo el amor y el soporte que nos dan las personas.
And is there anything, obviously you have a lot of fans and friends and family back home that is very important that helped get you here. If you can tell them anything right now, they're watching and they're cheering for you, what would you tell them?
Gracias. Gracias a todos.
A todos por el aguante, por esos lugares que nunca llegamos, por practicar este deporte. Creo que, nada, es otra ayuda más del corazón.
Gracias a todos.
It's beautiful. Congratulations, guys. We're so proud of you. I think everyone was chanting and cheering and so excited to see where you're going to go next. And you guys started here. If you can help out, let's do what we can. Like, let's come together. Roller Derby is such an amazing community, and they've worked hard and they put in all the work off on the track. So let's make sure that they can get there.